Spooky action at a distance. Albert Einstein used these words to express his disbelief about a certain interpretation of quantum mechanics. In this video, we will take a look at entanglement and the Einstein-Podolsky-Rosen paradox and see whether physics is really spooky or not. The fascinating, although confusing thing about quantum mechanics is that the wave function psi does not uniquely determine the outcome of an experiment. It only provides us with probabilities of the different outcomes. So how does it happen that one particular outcome is a result when we perform a measurement? One possible way to answer this would be that the wave function already knew which outcome would be the result before we even measured it. If this were correct, then the quantum mechanics as we have it today would be an incomplete theory. If the wave function really knows the result before the measurement, why is this not accounted for in the theory? Maybe we should introduce an additional parameter, call it lambda, which contains the necessary information that determines the outcome. So two wave functions that might look the same now could really be distinguished by their hidden parameter lambda. And by using lambda in our calculations, we should be able to precisely predict the outcome of a quantum mechanical measurement. No more probabilities. Including this hidden parameter lambda apparently solves our question. Therefore, not accounting for lambda makes our current theory of quantum mechanics incomplete. In 1935, Einstein, Podolsky and Rosen designed a thought experiment in order to prove that quantum mechanics is indeed incomplete and that we need to refine it somehow. For this video, we will consider a simplified version of their thought experiment introduced by David Bohm. We consider the decay of a neutral pion into an electron and a positron. In the rest frame of the pion, the electron and positron move apart in exact opposite directions. Since the pion has spin zero, the spins of the electron and the positron must point in opposite directions. Mathematically, we can express the composite system of two spins like this. These three expressions correspond to the total spin 1 case, and this one corresponds to the total spin 0 case. This is a so-called entangled state. The definition of an entangled state is that it cannot be written as the product of two states. And if we measure the first spin, let's say that's the spin of the electron, as up, then there is no other possibility than that the spin of the positron must be down. Here comes the tricky part. Let's assume that after the pion decays, we let the electron and the positron fly far away, really far. 10 meters, 10 kilometers, 10 light years. If we measure one spin, then we know that someone 20 light years away will 100% measure the other spin in the opposite orientation. This apparently transmits information much faster than the speed of light, and Einstein called this spooky action at a distance. The EPR paradox relies on the principle that no information can travel faster than the speed of light. This is called the principle of locality and is the basis for Einstein's special theory of relativity. So you can surely understand why Einstein didn't like the idea that nature has a way to communicate faster than light. So at this point we basically have two options. One, that there are indeed hidden variables that already decide the spin the moment the pion decays. This way, no information is ever transmitted. Both particles already knew in which direction their spins would point during the experiment. Or two, that nature is simply non-local and that there is stuff that happens faster than the speed of light. The answer came almost 30 years later, delivered by John Stuart Bell and his famous inequalities. They absolutely deserve a video on their own, so to keep things short, the argument goes like this. If Bell's inequalities hold true, then we cannot have any hidden parameters and nature really behaves non-locally. If Bell's inequalities fail, then we have to modify our theory of quantum mechanics and introduce lambda somewhere. There have been many, many experiments to verify Bell's inequalities, and so far they have all shown that these equations hold true. There are no hidden variables. But what does this mean for Einstein's special theory of relativity? Well, if we think about it, we cannot actually cause anything to happen using this form of entanglement. Sure, the measurement of the electron spin influences the measurement of the positron spin, but since we cannot choose the electron spin to be a certain way, we cannot cause an effect at the other detector. Let's imagine you at the electron detector and someone else at the positron detector. Let's say you two agree that if you measure up, you will go a step forward, and if you measure down, you will move a step backwards. When it's time to perform the experiment, maybe you measure up. You take a step forward and immediately know that many light years away, your friend takes a step backwards, even before information of this action could reach you via light. Knowing this early might lead to some advantages in certain situations. For more information, look up the term quantum pseudo-telepathy. However, the important aspect is that you cannot choose which information to send. If we look at this case in a Minkowski diagram, we can see that the two measurements are space-like separated. This means we cannot even say which comes first. There is always a frame of reference where your event happens first, and there are other frames of reference where the other event happens first. So these events can influence each other, yes. But as special relativity dictates, we cannot cause an effect at the other detector by actively choosing what kind of information we want to send. So while there is no true spooky action at a distance, there is some kind of spooky influence at a distance, which we call entanglement. But that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.